Filipino-American stand-up comedian Joe Coy will host the 81st Golden Globe Awards this January. This marks his first ever hosting role for a major awards show. Joe Coy is known for his relatable comedy that pulls inspiration from his Filipino family. His recent Funny is Funny World Tour broke sales records at some of the most prestigious venues around the world. A former assistant, American actor Vin Diesel, is suing him for sexual battery. In her lawsuit, the assistant alleges Diesel sexually assaulted her in 2010 while the actor was working on the movie Fast Five. She adds she was fired from her job hours after the incident. The lawsuit said the victim remained silent for years, afraid to speak out against one of the world's highest-paid actors. Vin Diesel's camp has yet to issue a comment. Hamas rules out any more hostage releases until Israel agrees to a full cessation of aggression in Gaza. The militant group's statement comes as negotiations for a new truce continue in Egypt. Initial talks on Wednesday, however, bore no agreement. Israel has said the best way to rescue the 120 remaining hostages is military pressure on Hamas. The over two-month-old war has killed at least 20,000 Palestinians, with over a million more displaced. Tragedy in Prague. At least 15 are killed and dozens more injured after a gunman went on a shooting spree. The suspect reportedly shot his father first in a town outside the Czech capital before continuing his rampage at the Charles University, where he killed 14 people. The suspect, who was a student at the school, also took his own life. Authorities are still investigating his motive. Well, the government of the Czech Republic declares December 23 a national day of mourning. Thursday's incident was the country's worst ever mass shooting. Witnesses also recall how they escaped the rampage and how they checked on their loved ones at the university.
From what happened in the beginning, there was a couple of banks. I didn't even realize it's a shooting. I was just, you know, ready to admit that something like that could happen in Prague. When I got through the crowd and I realized that there's the policemen, you know, fully equipped with the automatic rifles, covered in Kevlar helms, Kevlar vests, I realized that okay, this is something going on. This is wrong.
The guys from the special forces told me that the attack, it's happening in the faculty, which was for me even more stressful because my daughter was over there. After a few minutes, I get in the connection with her through SMS, short messages, and I was giving their instruction like not to be next to the window, lay down, barricade the door, and I was trying to stay in contact with her. But meanwhile, there was a repeating shooting, and I was helping the police because a lot of people was approaching the scene where was the active shooter.
President Marcos Jr. stands by the Philippines' decision to boost alliances to help defend its sovereignty amid China's acts of aggression at sea. Let's hear more from Bianca Dava.
Most Reverend
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. described the recent incidents in the West Philippine Sea as worrisome. During the December 10 resupply mission, Chinese ships shadowed and conducted dangerous maneuvers against Philippine ships and boats, delivering fresh provisions to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre in Ayungin Shoal. A China Coast Guard vessel even blasted water cannon and rammed one of the supply boats, Unai Zamay 1, carrying AFP Chief General Romeo Bronner Jr. But the president added, the incident also showed Filipino courage against coercion.
The recent incidents involving no less than our AFP Chief of Staff is worrisome. Yes, but it is a proud demonstration of Filipino courage against coercion and our firm resolve to protect, preserve, and uphold our territorial integrity.
Marcos Jr. made the statement during the celebration of the 88th founding anniversary of the AFP at Camp Aguinaldo in Quezon City on Thursday. The AFP commander-in-chief lauded the military for exemplifying responsible and dignified behavior in resolving issues in the region in accordance with international law.
The Philippines has found itself in the middle of geopolitical developments and tensions that could potentially cause regional insecurity or endanger people's lives and livelihoods. But despite the many attempts at provocation, the Philippines, through the AFP, remains a force and a voice of reason, exemplifying responsible and dignified behavior in resolving issues in accordance with international law. We shall continue to assert our rights in accordance with the Philippine Constitution and international law. I know that our soldiers and our troops espouse the same values and principles, and they remain undeterred by actions that stir tension. The AFP must continue to improve its readiness to effectively prevent and to respond to properly the current and emerging threats.
Marcos Jr. also enjoined the AFP to enhance existing alliances and partnership with its foreign counterparts.
This administration remains committed to supporting initiatives that will bolster our armed forces' external defense capabilities. It is my hope that you and the rest of the military force will continue to uphold the AFP core values of honesty, service, patriotism in every endeavor.
This was echoed by Cagayan de Oro Representative Rufus Rodriguez, who urged the chief executive to seek the aid of the United States in preventing future Chinese attacks in the West Philippine Sea. Rodriguez believes a paradigm shift is needed in dealing with Chinese aggression, saying repeated protests have fallen on deaf ears. This comes as China called out the Philippine government to properly manage the maritime row as a top priority. In a phone call to Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, China's top diplomat Wang Yi demanded a course correction on the part of Manila, saying bilateral relationships now stands at a crossroads. He also rehashed statements from Beijing's foreign ministry on how Manila is the one stirring trouble. As for the Philippines, Manalo says both sides underscore the importance of dialogue in addressing issues. In the meantime, AFP Chief of Staff Romeo Bronner Jr. noted that the AFP has been strengthening the country's territorial defense operations.
By heightening our presence in our key maritime domain and intensifying our maritime security operations as a response to the increasing challenges to our sovereignty and territorial integrity. We stand at the pivotal juncture where enhancing our military capabilities becomes not just an option, but a strategic imperative.
Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.